Hi all, this is VC here from VC's Academy. In today's class, we will discuss about chrysophytes. As we have discussed about kingdom protista in my previous video, this is chrysophytes. So what chrysophytes contains or what are all in chrysophytes? Chrysophytes group includes diatoms and golden algae. So what are included in this group? Diatoms and golden algae are included in this group. Golden algae is also called as desmites. These are found in freshwater as well as marine habitat or environments. So where we can find chrysophytes? Chrysophytes can be found in freshwater as well as marine habitat or environment. So both freshwater and marine, both are the habitats for chrysophytes. These are microscopic in nature and floats passively in water currents, and these are mostly photosynthetic. Chrysophytes are mostly photosynthetic and microscopic in nature, and when we see the movement, these float passively in water currents. So what are the points which are included in chrysophytes? Diatoms and golden algae are included in this group. And these are found in freshwater as well as marine habitats, microscopic in nature and photosynthetic with passive floating movement in water currents. In diatoms, if we observe, the cell walls form two thin overlapping shells called epitheca and hypotheca. So what are the cell walls are formed of? These cell walls are formed of two thin overlapping shells called epitheca and hypotheca. Epitheca over hypotheca, which fits together as in a soap box. When we observe a soap box, how it fits the lower one with the upper one, in the same way, the walls are embedded with silica and thus the walls are indestructible. Due to the walls are filled with or fixed with silica, these walls are indestructible. Diatoms have left behind large amounts of cell wall deposits in their habitats. So what are the left behind? Diatoms left huge deposits of cell walls in their habitat, and this accumulation over billion of years referred as diatomaceous earth or kieselguhe. Due to the accumulation, what happens? The silica deposits are left behind and makes the soil gritty. Being gritty, this soil is used in polishing, filtration of oils and making of syrups. Once again, in diatoms, the cell walls form two thin overlapping shells called epitheca and hypotheca. Epitheca fits over hypotheca as it fits in soap box. The walls are embedded with silica and thus the walls are indestructible. Diatoms have left behind large amount of cell wall deposits in their habitat, and this accumulation over billions of years is referred as diatomaceous earth or kieselguhe. Due to the grittiness of the soil, this soil is used in polishing, filtration of oils and making of syrups. Diatoms are divided into two types based on their structural symmetry. So when we observe diatoms, these are broadly divided into two types based on the structural symmetry. So what are they? They are central diatoms and pinnate diatoms. Central and pinnate are the two types of diatoms based on their structural symmetry. Central diatoms are radially symmetrical and pinnate diatoms are bilaterally symmetrical. If we observe the reproduction process, reproduction in diatoms is asexually by binary fission and sexually by formation of gametes. Oxospores are formed as a result of sexual reproduction, and these are rejuvenatory spores. And as a result of sexual reproduction, the spores formed are called as oxospores, and these are rejuvenatory spores. And finally, diatoms are chief producers in the oceans. So what are the points here? And diatoms are divided into two types based on their structural symmetry. They are central diatoms and pinnate diatoms. Central diatoms are radially symmetrical. Pinnate diatoms are bilaterally symmetrical. And these reproduce asexually by binary fission and sexually by formation of gametes. And as a result of sexual reproduction, oxospores are formed, and these oxospores are regenerative spores, and diatoms are the chief producers in the oceans. That's all about chrysophytes. In my next class, we'll discuss about dinoflagellates and all. Thank you. Hope you all understood the concept.